Hello guys, welcome to my channel. In this session, I'm going to write some code to generate the access token for OAuth 2.0, the authorization framework. So I hope you have a basic understanding of OAuth 2.0. Let's get started. So every API can be secured through one or the other authorization framework. So this is a Postman tool basically. And when you click on this authorization, you can see the different authorization frameworks available, like API key, bearer token, OAuth 2.0, and AWS signature. So you need to know what is the authorization framework your application is using. So in this example, I'm going to cover OAuth 2.0 for my API. So let me show you first manually how we generate an access token through Postman, and then we will do it through a program. So in order to generate an access token through Postman, you need to have the access token URL, the client ID and client secret, which is the ID and password of the application. Also guys, you need to understand is the grant type. Here you see is it can be authorization code, it can be password credential, or it can be client credential. You can use any of them. So currently, for my application, we have the grant type set as client credential. So after populating all these details, when you click on get new access token, you see the access token is generated. You can use this access token and you can make the HTTP request. Also, one important thing here you need to notice the client authentication. It can be means the client credential, the ID and password. It can be sent as a basic authentication header, or the client credentials can be sent in the body. So for this particular API, if you send the client credentials in the body and generate the access token, you see it has failed. So the application does not allow, the authorization server does not allow the client credentials to be sent in the body. So you need to send the client credential as a header. So when you select this and you generate, it will be generated. So this is manually, this is very simple. Postman has made it very simple to generate the access token. And then you can use this access token to make the HTTP request. Now let's see how we can do it through a program. So let me create a class, this token class. In this program, we will be using the access token URL, ID, secret, and grant type. So let's create strings, client ID, and then pass the value. This is the sample value, client secret. And pass the client secret. Yeah. Third thing is token URL. This is the token URL currently I'm using, the sandbox PayPal. So now we have the client ID string, client secret, token URL, and we need to generate the access token, or we can say final token. Let's create final token. And the authorization which will be sent as the token will be a bearer value, so we'll come to that later. Let's initialize it. Now, after initializing, declaring these string variables, let's see what dependency we are using for this particular access request. So we are using the Apache Alto Auth dependency in order to generate the access token. So let me create a object of auth client. So you need to add this particular dependency from Apache in order to make the in order to get the access token. So auth client and this accepts URL connection as input. So now we have the object of auth client. Let's create an access request. Auth client access request. This is the request that we'll be sending. Auth client request dot. So we are creating the request by adding all these parameters, the URL, the grant type, and everything. So token location will be token URL. Next thing is grant type. You can use the grant type class here, grant type client credential. Then build the body message because we are creating the body of this particular request. Why it is throwing error? Let's see. Okay, handle the exception. So now we have the request created, the body of the request created. Now we need to add the header to the request. Now, as you know, like for this API, only the basic authentication header will be accepted. So let's create one more method that will generate the base64 encoded value. ID, comma, string, password. Let's pass these two variables, string variables. Return base64 dot get encoder dot encode dot string. Now this accepts the byte array. Let's pass the ID. Password. The byte form. So the requirement here is the ID and password needs to be separated by colon, get bytes, close the bracket, semicolon. So now we have created this method that will return the base64 encoded value of ID and password, which needs to be separated by colon in the input. So let's create another variable encoded value was to get base64 encoded ID password. So our ID is the client ID and password is client secret. So we have one method that returns the BASIC64 encoded value. We have these variables with initialized with these values. We create an object of auth client. We create the access, create the body of the access request, and then we'll add the header to this request. Add header. Name will be authorization. Now here, the request accepts it as a BASIC64 encoded value, which will be in this format, BASIC, because it is a BASIC authentication header, BASIC. And then the encoded value. So it will look like something BASIC space and then the encoded value, because this is the format that it accepts. So we have the body of the request. We have added the header to the request. Now let's execute this request. The response will be of auth JSON. So JSON response. Pass this object. Dot access token. You can use any of this constructor. First will be the request it's asking. Then it is asking for the request method. So you can add the request method http.post method within this particular class is available. The response class will be OAuth JSON response. So it is expecting expression class. Okay, just handle this exception. So now we have this OAuth JSON access token response object created. Next thing is, we'll get the token value from this response. So final token equals to auth response dot get access token. This will return be the access token from this particular response. Now, as you know, right, that the authorization that you need to add in the header in the postman, you can see is it needs to be bearer followed with the access token value, because this is the format that the API understands. The access token should be of bearer type. So write bearer value equals to bearer. Now let's print this bearer value just to make sure that it's correct. We are getting some value. Let's run this. Okay, let's see whether we are able to generate a value. So you see, we got the access token and then we appended bearer before that, so that our value will be bearer space access token, because this is what we need to add in the header of the HTTP request so that we can get a valid response. Guys, this is a programmatically way of generating the access token for OAuth when you have the grant type as client credential. When you use authorization code, you have other fields, so you can modify this code further to implement the other grant types. Thank you guys. Please do subscribe my channel and like, comment if you like my video. Thank you.